In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and humbly ask for pardon and mercy as we celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Bestow on us, we pray, O Lord, the wisdom and strength of the cross, with which you were pleased to endow Saint Rita, so that, suffering in every tribulation with Christ, we may participate ever more deeply in his Paschal mystery, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated. A reading from the letter of Saint James. Beloved, come now, you who say, today or tomorrow we shall go into such and such a town, spend a year there doing business and make a profit. You have no idea what your life will be like tomorrow. You are a puff of smoke that appears briefly and then disappears. Instead, you should say, if the Lord wills it, we shall live to do this or that. But now you are boasting in your arrogance. All such boasting is evil. So for one who knows the right thing to do and does not do it, it is a sin. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, the kingdom of heaven is theirs.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, the kingdom of heaven is theirs.
Hear this, all you peoples. Hearken, all who dwell in the world, of lowly birth or high degree, rich and poor alike.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, the kingdom of heaven is theirs.
Why should I fear in evil days when my wicked snarers ring me round? They trust in their wealth, the abundance of their riches is their boasts.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, the kingdom of heaven is theirs. Yet no way can a man redeem himself or pay his own ransom to God. Too high is the price to redeem one's life. He would never have enough to remain alive always and not see destruction.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, the kingdom of heaven is theirs.
For he can see that wise men die, and likewise the senseless and the stupid pass away, leaving no others their wealth.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, the kingdom of heaven is theirs. Please stand.
The truth and the life, says the Lord. No one comes to the Father except through me.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
John said to Jesus, "Teacher, we saw someone driving out demons in your name, and we tried to prevent him because he does not follow us." Jesus replied, "Do not prevent him. There is no one who performs a mighty deed in my name who can at the same time speak ill of me. For whoever is not against us is for us." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
One of the lessons that I will never forget from a former seminary formator were these words from him: proper time, proper place, and proper purpose. At ano po ang ibig niyang sabihin sa mga salitang iyon? Kung oras ng aral, naroroon ka dapat sa tamang oras ng pag-aaral at marahil sa lugar ng pag-aaralan at maging seryoso sa pag-aaral. Hindi oras ng aral, nasa laruan at naglalaro. Something to that effect. But what is meaningful is the last phrase, proper purpose, tamang layunin. And my dear brothers and sisters, this is something that we might need to learn, rediscover, and maybe regain that proper acknowledgement of proper purpose of the many things that we have today in life. Our readings may be so short, but they have a lot to share with us. James left a strong remark towards the end. "For one who knows the right thing to do and does not do it, it is a sin." While Jesus gave a strong reminder to all of us, there is no one who performs a mighty deed in my name who can at the same time speak ill of me. They are all teaching us to embrace proper purpose. It is the grace that we might need to ask today, my dear brothers and sisters, to see the proper purpose of ourselves, of what we have, of the faith that we believe, on the things that we are doing, and even our own mission of bringing the Lord to others. Those who drive out demons in the name of Jesus knew very well the purpose of the name of Christ, and that is why they succeeded. Kaya siguro sila nagtagumpay dahil alam nila kung ano ang layunin at ano ang dapat gawin sa pangalan ni Jesus. But if they lost the sense of purpose, I think they will lose the fight. And again, my dear brothers and sisters, it is for us to see. You have the talent, you have the energy, and you have the time, and many others. May mga layunin po yan, bakit iyan ang nasa ating. Let us know its purpose so that we can have a blessed outcome after. We have faith, then let us see its purpose. That is why we will keep on inspiring others. We will do our little thing of evangelization, teach others to pray, and so on. Because when we begin to see purpose, to see proper purpose, we won't waste it. We might not be so different from it, but then we will value it and see it as a blessing. My dear brothers and sisters, whatever God is giving us, there is always a side-by-side purpose for it. Even purposes are sacred. And let us value these purposes so that we can see it deeply as a grace of God and as God's blessings for us.
Please stand.
Let us pray the Oratio Imperata ad Petendam Pluviam together. God, our loving Father, creator of our earth and of the universe, and of all the wondrous elements of nature that sustain your living creatures, we humbly ask you to grant us relief from the extreme heat that besets your people
at this time, disrupting their activities and threatening their lives and livelihood.
Send us rain to replenish our depleting water sources, to irrigate our fields, to stave off water and power shortages, and to provide water for our daily needs. At your command, the wind and the seas obey. Raise your hand, Almighty God,
to avert the continuing rise in temperatures so that your people can engage in productive undertakings and our young people can pursue learning in tranquility and comfort.
Merciful and generous God, open our eyes to the richness and beauty of your creation and instill in us a deep love for this earth and all that is in and around it.
Teach us to be wise stewards of your creation, so that we may always use them responsibly and protect them from abuse and exploitation. At this time of crisis, dear Lord, move us to share more, to serve more, and to love more. Loving God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, you entrusted the Filipino people to the special care of Mary, our Mother. Listen to the prayers that we bring up to her, our Blessed Mother, to intercede for us, for the protection of our land and our people, whom she loves. Grant this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
Our Lady of Guadalupe,
pray for us.
Saint Rose of Lima,
pray for us.
San Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
San Pedro Calunsod,
pray for us. Please be seated. please stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
Most merciful God, who were pleased to create in Blessed Rita the new man in your own image, the old having passed away, graciously grant, we pray, that renewed like her, we may offer you the acceptable sacrifice of conciliation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the saints who consecrated themselves to Christ for the sake of the kingdom of heaven, it is right to celebrate the wonders of your providence, by which you call human nature back to its original holiness, and bring it to experience on this earth the gifts you promise in the new world to come. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with Saint Rita of Cassia, and all of the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
ay pinaspasan, di natin inialam. Buhay na kana ang sa aming kaloob at pagsasalo.
Please stand.
Let us pray. By the power of this sacrament, Lord, we pray, lead us always in your love through the example of Blessed Rita, and bring to fulfillment the good work you have begun in us until the day of Christ Jesus, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Our Wednesday Family Rosary tonight will be hosted by the San Isidro Labrador Parish in Meycauayan, Bulacan. Let us gather this night in the presence of our families and ask the Blessed Mother to pray for us and continue leading us always to the heart of her Son. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration has been offered. Go forth in the peace and love of Christ.
Thanks be to God.